Let me begin by saying everyone here at Panama Schools is very saddened by this pandemic in which you, our seniors, have had to endure this spring.
Seniors have missed out on baseball, softball, competing at the powerlifting state tournament, performing at the state band competition, their senior trip, their last senior walk, and social interactions with friends and teachers.
We want to challenge each of you seniors to not dwell on the negatives of this pandemic, but I ask that you reflect on all your academic accomplishments to this point.
That being said, we are excited to have the first graduation ever at the Poto Drive-In Theater.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Thank you.
Hello, graduates, families, and friends. I am State Superintendent Joy Hoffmeister, and I'm honored to be part of one of the most unique graduation ceremonies in the state. Panama Razorback Seniors, have you been picturing this momentous day for the last 13 years? I can certainly understand if this ceremony isn't at all what you had in mind when you envisioned your graduation a few months ago. This global pandemic has reinvented the way we are doing everything, including your senior year. It has changed the trajectory of your learning and impacted how you finished your very last year of high school. Being a part of this memorable graduation today reminds me of a quote from author C.S. Lewis. He said, "Hardships often prepare ordinary people for extraordinary destiny." Graduates, you have shown leadership and character through this hardship, and I'm so proud of you. Now is the time for your extraordinary destiny. Use the fire that you've channeled during this global pandemic to push forward. Know that when an obstacle lands in your path, your generation, the digital natives, will determine how to move around it. I have faith that if you work diligently toward your goals for success, you will help us build a world where we can make it through anything. The world may be forever changed, but this is your generation's opportunity to help shape the future. I believe in you. Congratulations, Panama Senior Class of 2020.
I always knew this day would come. We'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. I always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears. But never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so hard to say goodbye. But yesterday's gone, we gotta keep moving.
I'll always
will remember you. Will you remember me? It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again. Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear, it's the truth, and I owe it all to you.
I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before.
Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really wanna live forever, forever, and never?
Time of your life.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, hope you choose the one that means the most to you.
Hope you still feel small when you stand beside the ocean. Whenever one door closes, I hope one more opens. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance.
And if it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything,
I hope you dance.
That dream I'm dreaming, there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. But I gotta keep trying, gotta keep my head held high. My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Water rises, you build a wall. And hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you'll stay.
It's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't
ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
I did it all.
It is my pleasure to introduce to you your class of 2020 salutatorian, Haley Bell.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Panama's first ever virtual high school graduation. I would like to say thank you to our faculty and staff who made this whole thing possible. We appreciate all your hard work and effort. I am honored to be up here giving this speech because I have worked so hard to be in this position, and there is so much that I would like to say to the class of 2020 and my other peers at Panama High. I wasn't sure we'd all make it here, but we did, so I'd like for the class of 2020 to think about their fellow classmates and remember all the memories that we have shared. Although our graduation was not ideal, I'm thankful that we all did get the opportunity to walk across the stage and receive our diplomas. So I guess that means we made it, guys. 4 years of high school flies by faster than most of us would like to admit. We have gone through many variety shows, several Hug Olympics, and have done so many class fundraisers, but it's those things that we are going to miss the most. It feels like just yesterday we were little freshies walking through the hallways trying to navigate to our next class. We have all grown so much, and we all turned out to be the people our parents were trying to raise us to be, hopefully. Although most people would say high school has been the time of their lives, there are many obstacles we have had to face. Bad grades, oversleeping, missing class, procrastinating assignments, and staying up all night just to study for tests. But we made it. Through all those things, we are now moving on with the next chapter of our lives. The biggest bump in the road we have had to face this year is the ongoing coronavirus, which we feared would take away our last weeks of school, and sure enough, it did. It definitely took away some precious moments from us, like a normal graduation, our sports banquet, senior skip day, senior prank, baccalaureate, the last season of athletics, and so much more. Even though we have missed so important events, we still have something that no virus and anything else can take away from us. That's our memories. We still can hold tight to our precious memories and accomplishments that we have created and earned throughout high school. No one can take those things away from us. Memories are what we take with us after graduation. Throughout my 13 years of school at Panama, I have made a lifetime of memories, and I'm sure you all have too. Together as a class, we've laughed together, cried on each other's shoulders, and watched each other grow. And although it is fun to look back at all the fun and exciting times we have had, it's time to end this chapter of our lives and begin a new one. These past 4 years have been just a portion of our lives. My hope is that the class of 2020 will be fearless when venturing out into the real world. Don't be scared to take a chance and try something new. Opportunities come and go with the blink of an eye. Don't miss the chance of a lifetime because you are afraid. Writing my speech, I realized that everyone, including myself, was so wound up with making the grades, taking college classes and social media, that we may not have experienced high school to the fullest. I wish I could have had the experience of unwavering school spirit or close friendships with my classmates, but that was not always the case for me. Although I did make some of my best friends that I could have ever asked for that were lower classmen, and they made my last year of high school the best. So with all that being said, I would like to leave these words for the younger generations of Panama schools. Make the most out of these 4 years, because that's all you get. Do not worry about what others think of you. Be goofy. Do not be embarrassed to show school spirit. Start that student section and encourage every club and organization to do their best. Dress as crazy as possible during Spirit Week, make friends with someone new in your class, sign up for the variety show, and make a fool of yourself. Join a club and make a difference, because those memories are what make high school worth it. Kevin Hart once said, "Life is too short to worry about what others say about you. Have fun and give them something to talk about." I can promise you, 10 years from now, nobody will remember what your grades were, how many college classes you took, or how awesome you were at sports, but they will never forget your kindness and impact on the school. I've had the privilege of having some amazing mentors in my life, and I would like to take this time right now to thank them. Coach Kobe, Coach Hoffman, Coach House, I'm so grateful that you all took the time out of your lives to teach and show me your love for softball. Although Coach Kobe may not have loved my decision to play my freshman year, you all spend countless hours out there on those fields, even though you don't have to, and it is seen and it is appreciated so much. Coach Rogers, thank you for always having my back and being someone I can go to if I needed anything. You're very appreciated. Miss Leota, I may have only had your class for a year, but I learned so much in our government class, more than I think I've learned in any class at the high school, and I will never forget the knowledge that you have given me. Miss Black, I know that some people may not have been able to take you, push them to be their best, but I needed someone like you in my life to push me to be my best and teach me that it's better to learn the material than to finish the work. Coach Denton, I can't thank you enough for the impact you had on me. God knew exactly what he was doing when he put you in my life. You taught me so many valuable lessons on the court, but mostly off the court, and I will forever be thankful for you. Lastly, to the woman who does it all, she is my counselor, my shoulder to cry on, my best friend, my mom and dad all in one. She did it all on her own, and I have learned to thank her for getting me to where I am now. Mom, you've taught me what it looks like to be independent, and I'm blessed to be able to say that you're my mom. Finally, to the class of 2020, go be something extraordinary. Be something that nobody expected you to be. Your past is in the past. Don't make excuses. Venture out. Go somewhere new. I know this place is home to most of you here, but there is so much more world to see and explore. I can assure you that the way people perceive you in this town is not how you'll be perceived at college. Go make a new you and start fresh. You can be whoever you want to be at college or even at work without the pressure to fit in. As Donald Trump once said, I like thinking big. If you're going to be thinking anything, might as well think big. Reach for the stars, guys. Make something of yourself and be the person that you want to be. Thank you guys for everything, and I hope to see you again soon. See ya.
Hello, everyone. My name is Kagan Monks, and I'm the 2020 class president. In fourth grade, I was introduced to Michaela Howard. How do I say this? My first impression of Michaela was not the best. Probably because she only talked to people who had a cell phone. Little did I know, 6 years later, she would be more than just a friend. She would be my sister. Now, fighting over a cell phone seems so small. Now we fight over the bathroom, the ice cream in the freezer, and what we are watching on TV. Oh, how times have changed. That will change in the fall, when Michaela moves to Stillwater to attend OSU, majoring in biology pre-med. Michaela's hard work, accomplishing 37 college credit hours during our high school days, helped her achieve the valedictorian spot of 2020. So, it is with great honor that I get to introduce this year's class valedictorian, my sister, Michaela Howard. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Before I start my speech, I want to take a moment to thank Mr. Walden, Mr. Hoffman, members of the board, and the rest of the Panama High School staff for giving us, in all due respect, the most memorable graduation this decade will ever witness. You all went above and beyond to provide us with the opportunities to achieve one of the greatest milestones of our lives. I also want to thank a few teachers individually. I want to thank Mr. Ives for always providing the laugh we needed to get through the day, Ms. Kobe for always trying to keep us involved and helping us out anytime we didn't like what was for lunch, and Ms. Toby for the genuine kindness she showed. I also want to thank Coach Pierce and Coach Tackett for always having confidence in me, even when I didn't have confidence in myself. And lastly, but definitely not least, Ms. Hobson. Thank you for giving each of us the tools we needed for the next step in our lives. She does so much behind the scenes for students and will never get the recognition she deserves. I've spent countless of hours in her office. Each time, she would greet me with a smile and be ready to help me with whatever I needed. And for that, I'm grateful. So that brings me to this, my speech, my farewell, my thank yous, and my acknowledgments. You know, the stuff a valedictorian speech is supposed to be. Well, when I was told to have my speech prepared, I worked ideas over and over in my head. I pondered, I wrote, I typed. I just tried to put something together. I did this over and over. I didn't know what to say, and I didn't have the words. I was lost on what could easily be said versus what needed to be said. You see, our graduation is different than any other graduation. Our graduation needs to make a statement. So I went to my living room. I sat on my couch thinking, what do I write about? What can I say? Here I am sitting on my couch when I should be in Miss Belcher's class listening to her talk about the new trick she found on the handheld. Or in the library trying to work on college classes while listening to Cal and Kagan talk about how much they want to skip the next hour. But no, I'm at home on the couch. I'm sitting here thinking to myself how nice it would be to run to the cafeteria, fight to be first, listen to Miss Leodiel, go around. But no, I'm on the couch. I start writing, scribble, and toss. I picture in my head what is going on in Miss Rise's class. Is she at the board trying to get College Menezes' attention? Is she screaming for Kaylee Hamilton to stop sitting on the top of her desk? I don't know. I can't see it because I'm quarantined on this couch. I should be happy. Heck, I didn't even get the chance to get senioritis. We don't have to get up early for school or use the stinky bathrooms. We don't have to worry about teachers yelling at us for running in the halls or wearing our hats in the building. We have no worries now. But that is the farthest thing from the truth. Why? Because no matter what any generation says about our generation, we have learned in the past 2 months that we need people. Yeah, they all think all we need is social media, but we need so much more than that. And we've learned that about ourselves. We yearn to be surrounded by the people we love, the people who drive us crazy, those who make us mad, sad, loved, and appreciated. We need to be touched. We need to laugh and cry. We need to be reassured and criticized. We need people, and we need them close to us and in our lives. No social distancing will ever take away the love that we have for each other. I've never wanted to be surrounded by all of you in my entire life, and I know it is because you all were taken away from me sooner than expected. So, back on my couch, and this time with a smile on my face. I can write the speech. I can laugh at the fun times we all shared, because I know we will all create more. I know we can be successful and kind people in this sometimes glum world. We have created bonds that we will cherish for a lifetime. We have also gained confidence in our abilities. While this is the most significant accomplishment for me and many others, it does not have to be the best or the last. I challenge you all to accomplish more and to continue to be successful, even when times are hard. While we may be upset about the distance that we have to be apart, or the few months that were taken from us, or the senior traditions that we never got to cherish, we know this hard spell will not last forever. And one of these days, very soon, we will get to hug. We will get to be together all in one room. We will get to touch and laugh and do all the things we got to do before. We will get to go on with our normal life. And that will be a great day, the day we don't have to be 6 feet apart. Thank you.
Mary Kagan Moss. Mary Kagan Moss is receiving a $300 counselor scholarship to Carl Edwards State College, the Panama Alumni Scholarship for $500, and the Sunny Graves Memorial Scholarship for $350. Congratulations, Mary Kagan Moss. Ty Bailey Downs. Congratulations, Ty Bailey Downs. Katrina Wright. Katrina is receiving the Brooklyn Delaplanque Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $500. The Carl Edwards State College Scholars Program totaling $10,460, Oklahoma's Promise 4-year tuition waiver, and the Ronnie Taylor Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $300. Congratulations, Katrina Wright. Kylie Smith. Kylie Smith is receiving the Hamilton Family Scholarship in the amount of $200. Congratulations, Kylie Smith. Faith Lamora England. Faith England is receiving a four-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise.
Congratulations, Faith Lamora England. Brandon J.W. Wedge. Brandon Wedge is receiving a $500 scholarship from the Panama Alumni. Congratulations, Brandon J.W. Wedge. Allison Louise Cortez. Congratulations, Allison Louise Cortez. Dawson Bryce Jackson. Congratulations, Dawson Bryce Jackson. Jacob Joseph Davidson. Jacob Davidson is receiving the BP America Scholarship in the amount of $1,000. Congratulations, Jacob Joseph Davidson. Mason Anthony Kramer. Congratulations, Mason Anthony Kramer. Nicholas Clay Woodrow. Congratulations, Nicholas Clay Woodrow. Tanner James Hagler. Congratulations, Tanner James Hagler. Kyle Anthony Jimenez. Congratulations, Kyle Anthony Jimenez. Peyton Allen Rogers. Congratulations, Peyton Allen Rogers. Journey Moore. Congratulations, Journey Moore. Rory Savannah Nicole Oliver. Rory is receiving a 4-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise. Congratulations, Rory Savannah Nicole Oliver. Caitlin Ray. Congratulations, Caitlin Ray. Colton Bradley Reed. Congratulations, Colton Bradley Reed. Madison Walker. Madison Walker is receiving a General Foundation Scholarship from Carl Albert State College in the amount of $500. Congratulations, Madison Walker. Easton Bowden. Easton is receiving the post GI Bill from the Marines in the amount of $180,000. Congratulations, Easton Bowden. Avery Brim Plotman. Congratulations, Avery Brim Plopper. Benjamin Matthew Armijo. Benjamin is receiving the Post GI Bill from the Air Force in the amount of $100,000. He is receiving a 4-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise. Congratulations, Benjamin Matthew Armijo. Landon James Tackett. Congratulations, Landon James Tackett. Dylan Pickman. Congratulations, Dylan Pickman. Trevor Dean Bernhardt.
Give me a minute.
Congratulations, Trevor Dean Bernhardt. Landry K. Bulls. Landry is receiving a $500 scholarship from Pinnacle. Congratulations, Landry K. Bulls. Kirsten Dawn Anderson. Kirsten is receiving the Doug and Barbara Lockerbie Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $300, a Panama PTO Scholarship in the amount of $500, the Faye Ferguson Thomas Scholarship for $2,000, and from the University of Arkansas, Fort Smith, she is receiving the Academic Distinction Scholarship totaling $16,000. Congratulations, Kirsten Dawn Anderson. Kaylee Jean Hamilton. Congratulations, Kaylee Jean Hamilton. Malachi Emmanuel Bashirs. Congratulations. Malachi Emmanuel Bashirs. Raylee Michelle Yandel. Congratulations, Raylee Michelle Yandel. Dakota Autry. Dakota Autry is receiving the Post GI Bill from the National Guard in the amount of $80,000. He is also receiving a 4-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise. Congratulations, Dakota Autry. Connor Douglas Walton. Congratulations, Connor Douglas Walton. Brandon Wade Rivera. Congratulations, Brandon Wade Rivera. Eugene Lowell Butler. Congratulations, Eugene Lowell Butler. Colton Ray Carter. Congratulations, Colton Ray Carter. Jonathan Cross. Congratulations, Jonathan Cross. Taylor Adams. Congratulations, Taylor Adams. Brianna Lynn Heathcott. Congratulations, Brianna Lynn Heathcott. Gavin Keith Francis. Congratulations, Gavin Keith Francis. Brooklyn Christine Collins. Brooklyn is receiving a $1,200 room waiver from Eastern Oklahoma State College. Congratulations, Brooklyn Christine Collins. Abraham Tekla. Congratulations, Abraham Tekla. Brandon Kyrie Forrest. Congratulations, Brandon Kyrie Forrest. Victoria Kaylee Ann Shirey. Victoria Shirey is receiving a four-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise. Congratulations, Victoria Kaylee Ann Shirey. Haley Nicole Bell. Haley is receiving the Debbie Christenberry Morgan Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $200. She's receiving a four-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise. From Oklahoma State College, she will be receiving the Cowboy Covenant and Academic Opportunity Award totaling $13,352. Congratulations, Haley Nicole Bell. Callie Shea Darnell. Callie is receiving the C. Robert Reed Scholarship from the Community State Bank in the amount of $500, the Counselor Connection Scholarship from Northeastern State College in the amount of $500, and a four-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise. Congratulations, Callie Shea Darnell. Michaela Dawn Howard. Michaela is receiving the C. Robert Reed Scholarship from the Community State Bank in the amount of $500, the Dennis Hemphill Scholarship in the amount of $500. From the Oklahoma State University, she is receiving the Virginia Richmond Scholarship, Oklahoma Tuition Aid Grant, Rule of Law Scholarship, Academic Opportunity Award, and Cowboy Covenant totaling $23,252. Michaela is also receiving a four-year tuition waiver from Oklahoma's Promise, along with the Reverend Kenneth King Memorial Scholarship in the amount of $4,000. Congratulations, Michaela Dawn Howard. Wade Dow Hall. Congratulations, Wade Dow Hall.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present to you the graduating class of 2020.
Wait, okay, you can open your eyes. This is it, this is now, this is what I've been talking about. Looking out, can't you see forever? Take my hand, just take it in. This is the moment we won't forget. On top of the world, here together. If there ever was a time for a perfect kiss, this is it.
Congratulations, we're proud of you.
Kirsten, we love you. Here's a throwback pick.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Remember, go into this world and do well. But more importantly, go into this world and do good.
Congratulations, class of 2020, and my very best on your next adventure. You make me proud to be a Razorback.
Hey, graduates of 2020, just wanted to say I'm proud of you. I love you. It's been a long, fun ride. I know it was a little difficult at the end, but you guys handled it like champs. I wish you the best of luck in all your endeavors and everything that you do. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hey, congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations, 2020 seniors of Panama High School. I'm so proud of you. You've completed a major section of life's journey. And now you're going to start the new one. And I'm not going to lie to you, it's going to be hard sometimes, but it's going to be awesome sometimes too. I wish you the best. I love you, and congratulations.
Senior class of 2020, congratulations on your graduation. This is a day that you'll remember for the rest of your life. Go and do something great for yourself. Congratulations.
Hey seniors, I just want to say I'm proud of you guys and I'm excited for you about your future. We will miss you next year and wish you the best.
Hey guys, I just wanted to tell you that I'm really proud of you and everything you've accomplished, and to let you know that you made crossing the state line every day so worth it, and I'm going to miss you a lot.
Class of 2020, congratulations. I want to wish you lots of luck, tell you that I love you, and Three pieces of advice I would give you would be to, number one, be brave. Try those things that are difficult, that are challenging, and you might surprise yourself at what you can accomplish. Number two, I would like for you to be kind. Be kind to others and be kind to yourself. Give yourself room to make mistakes and learn from those mistakes. And number three, be real mindful of where you find your happiness. Don't put all your eggs in one basket, and learn something new about yourself. And most of all, know that we love you and we're gonna miss you so much. And we just wish you all the happiness that you can go get. Congratulations.
Congratulations, 2020 seniors, especially Kaylee, Brandon, Abraham, and Faith. I am so proud of what you have done in band this year. Thank you.
Congratulations, seniors of 2020, from all of us at Panama Lower Elementary.
Hey, 2020 graduates, congratulations on your graduation and good luck in all your future
endeavors. Congratulations, seniors of 2020, go make a difference.
Congratulations, seniors, 2020. Special shout out to my daughter, Landry. Love you.
Congratulations, seniors. It's been my privilege to be your teacher while you were in high school. I will miss all of you, and I wish only the very best that life has for each and every one of you.
See if I can get it straight here. But I thought of you guys when I saw this. I hope you come back and see us. I'll make you some iced chest tea if you come back. Give me a day's notice. I sure miss you all.
Well, 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 the day you've been waiting for is finally here. Some of you are going to college and some of you are headed to work. Whatever it is you do, do it with your best efforts. If you have a plan, try to stick to that plan as far as it makes sense. You didn't give up to get this far. Don't give up on the next phase of your life. God bless you all.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You will be missed. Good luck. Go Razorbacks!
Congratulations, seniors of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Hey, seniors, congratulations. We are all so proud of you. You know, one of my favorite movies is Pretty Woman, and there's a line in there when Vivian is saying her goodbyes, and she said, "We think you got a lot of potential, Kit DeLuca." Well, I think all of you have a lot of potential, too. I can't wait to see what you accomplish in life. Come back and see us. We are going to miss you so much. We're so proud of you. I pray God's blessings on you. I pray he keeps you safe, healthy, and happy. Again, congratulations, seniors. See you later, alligators.
On behalf of the Board of Education, I'd like to congratulate the graduating class of 2020. And wish you well in your endeavors.
One tradition we seniors missed out on was the traditional cap throw. Staying in your vehicles if the class of 2020 would please remove your caps and throw them with us on the count of three. One, two, three.